Sagittarius, it's me, Stormy, and here is your annual horoscope for the year 2020, and welcome into the vibe of 2020. It is going to be a good year. I think it's going to be a busy year. We're going to do real life. Jupiter, your ruling sign, has moved out of your energy and moved into the energy of Capricorn, so it is a little bit more of a serious year for you, Sagittarius, and we're going to talk about that. We're going to cover some of these things, but the serious years, the big kid years, are the ones that really help us change. Those are the ones that show us what the heck we are really made of. Not only that, this year we've got Saturn and Pluto coming together at the beginning of the year. We've got Jupiter and Pluto dancing together multiple times this year, which supercharge you. They give those like Sonic the Hedgehog supercharge moments, you know, where you used to get the Chaos Diamond and you could just run forward and run through all the stuff. So those are going to be your helpers. As well, we've got Jupiter and Saturn coming together at the end of the year as our age rulers in the energy of Aquarius. So the business of this year is real. Not to mention, we do have 6 eclipses happening this year, and every planet that can will retrograde. So it is a year where what I'm going to tell you, Sag, is be patient, be prepared, and be willing to make adjustments and take some supercharged actions, because this is a big kid year for you. All right, let's jump in and look at this. Right at the beginning of the year, we've got this lunar eclipse that's happening in the energy of Cancer. So it's going to be at 20 degrees on January 10th. This is going to light up your 10th house space. Now, at the beginning of the year, we're coming into 2020, bringing some of the energy of 2019, that Capricorn Cancer axis. So we're still going to be dancing that until we get till about summertime. So some of the things that you have been working on, you will continue to work on, but at this particular point, there may be some kind of big adjustment or disruption that comes up that allows you to be able to make some greater changes and progress in this area. Now, this lunar eclipse is gonna happen in your 8th house. So the 8th house is the place of joint resources. So this could be changes, endings. You have to do some kind of acknowledgement, make a big adjustment in some way over the next 6 months to a partner's finance in some way, shape, or form. I also think of the 8th house just of intimacy, so your connection with other human beings. We're going to move into the Gemini Sagittarian axes this year, so you'll start to do a fair amount of work on relationships and connections and things like that, and some of this energy we may see starting to happen right here. The other thing I think about is debt. This is a financial house. This is your second financial house. The first one is the second house. So this is a financial house. Now on January 12th, we're gonna have Saturn and Pluto coming together in conjunction at 22 degrees of Capricorn. This lands in that second house. So now, the second house and the eighth house are activated. These are financial resources, the way you make money, the way you spend money, the way you're connected financially or collaboratively with other energies. So when Pluto and Saturn come together, they are just these intense bodies that create this slow evolutionary process. It's nice and slow. It usually has something to do with economics, but what they create is this energy where Pluto is like, hey, I need you to die off, Sagittarius, so that we can live in a more mature way, Capricorn. And Saturn says, yes, let's do that, because I'm going to level you up. I'm going to help you see your way through this. But what it feels like is some kind of loss or some kind of hardship that comes with the need of a big adjustment. Now, this is just 2 days after this lunar eclipse energy, so ultimately it kind of gets caught up in this as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if you have to have an ending, an acknowledgement, or an adjustment to something in your finances or how you make money. Something connected to that will definitely be an adjustment. The other thing I do think of in this arena is that because the 8th house is still so active, and we're gonna see it be active again, this is an energy of death of a sort, right? Yes, it could be so that you are dying off psychologically, right? Like something is dying off so that something else can live. It's a very much so a rebirth kind of place, but the other piece of this death energy is really you letting something go and allowing some healing in. Maybe old situations, old jobs, old investments are dying off, whatever it is. You'll see it in this first couple weeks of January and begin to make progress on it for the next 6 months. Mercury is going to retrograde 3 different times this year per the usual, February, June, and October, and I will cover those in the monthly videos and in individual breakdowns. But what you can do is watch my 2019 Mercury retrograde in your element video, because that'll be very much so. The retrogrades are pretty similar this year, and that will still apply as we travel forward. March 22nd, Saturn is going to move into the energy of Aquarius, but this is just for a little snack. It's like just a little quick preview of what's going to happen when Saturn moves more permanently into the energy of Sagittarius in December until 2023. Now, this is going to light up your third house space. Where Saturn goes, he's trying to mature you. He's trying to level you up. You've got to go to a new place. So right here, even if Saturn has been traveling through Capricorn in your third house already, maybe you have a split house, changing signs will change the way that this energy works and levels you up. In the energy of Aquarius, it's out of the box thinking, right? It's going to be new friends, new associations. It may just flat out be Sagittarius. You've got to come into some new understanding around technologies, groupings, causes, organizations, things like that. The third house, perhaps you are studying or getting something ready to teach. You could be writing a book. This could be even a book about conspiracies or something that you have recently found a passion in that you feel like it has a cause in some way, shape, or form, right? But either way, Saturn moving into this third house is going to refine your thinking, the way you communicate, the way you study, the way you learn, relationships with siblings. Saturn's going to dip in here and give this area some you need to grow up kind of energy. Now, you'll experience this preview from March until July, and then Saturn is going to retrograde, get back into that Capricorn energy. It'll just run back over there and peak to make sure you're still doing okay with your finances, and then it's going to come back forward in December, okay? May 13th through June 25th, we've got Venus retrograding in the energy of Gemini, which is just across the street from you. This is your opposite energy. So now, this is our first indicator that really, truly, this seventh house is about to be lit. There's going to be work. We're going to start new considerations here. So with Venus being retrograde, one of the things that we do recommend is during a Venus retrograde, you don't get married, you don't start a new romance, and you don't make big investments or big purchases or something like that. Because what happens is Venus comes out of retrograde and there are things that you just did not see. And it's usually quite troublesome down the road. Now, of course, you know, you do you. Life is life. We do not stop life because of astrology. These are just recommendations, okay? But Venus being in the energy of Gemini as well, I do feel like if you entered into a contract or something of something brand new during this Venus retrograde, you might find later that the wording, the details of that contract are something that maybe you don't fully agree to. So just kind of keep that in mind. Now, what this is great for during a Venus retrograde is to review. In the seventh house, you're reviewing your relationships, conscious, chosen, one-on-one relationships, marriages, partnerships, even if they're business partnerships. I do think some friendships will be reevaluated here. And most certainly, Sagittarius, the energy of you with you, the relationship of you with you as you relate to the world. This will be the time to re-look over those things, re-look over your connections, Gemini energy. Who are you connected with? Are you kind of being a hermit? Are you super too out there and you're all over the place? Because both Gemini and Sagittarius energies are good at kind of being splayed all over the place. So where do you maybe need to pull a little something back in? Or where are you even willing to go back to old associations, maybe even work or something that you can invest in, an old idea, an old creative talent, something like that, and you're able to bring that forward. Now, if you are single, I do think that this energy gives you an opportunity to reevaluate what you want in relationships, what you're willing to tolerate, what you bring to the table, right? All of these things will become an abundant set of information for you to reevaluate if that's something that you want into your life as well. And yes, honey, Venus retrograde can bring back old lovers in some way, shape, or form, okay? So just put that in your Saggy pipe and smoke it, okay? All right, June 5th, we have got a lunar eclipse happening in Sagittarius. This one's at 15 degrees. It's just after this, or it's just during this Venus retrograde. So again, there is this reevaluation and there is this ending to you. There is this acknowledgement. There is an adjustment that is going to take place over the next 6 months. And the energy will have been spurred from this Venus retrograde. What do you need to shift here, Sag? Where do you need to show up a little bit differently? Where are you ready to take a leap or an advancement? planet, right? Keep in mind that throughout here, April 4th, June 30th, and November 12th, we'll have Jupiter and Pluto coming into conjunction. And these energies are your helpers. We are here for these. These are those supercharged energies that help you take a really big leap in growth. It brings an opportunity. It is like you get to turn into this phoenix midair while you're taking this opportunity, and it is something good. These are indicators of positive change. This will all be working in your financial house for you. These are to help you with your finances, how you make money, your creative talents, the values you have, the possessions you have. If during Venus retrograde, you've got stuff in your house that you're like, I just need to clean out. I have got to clean out, sell it. And it's like, even if you paid $100 and you make $80 on it, that $80 turns into something else that you couldn't have imagined if you had demanded that you take more money. It's really interesting how these line up. So this will be a fresh start for you. Therefore, by bringing an ending, it will bring your beginning. All right, we have got June 22nd, a solar eclipse happening in the energy of Cancer at 0 degrees, lighting up that eighth house. Just after that, July 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening at 13 degrees of Capricorn, again, your second house. So this is gonna be our eclipse series that ends this Cancer Capricorn dance that we've been doing. Now, at this particular point, I think this is the opportunity that you have to do some super cleaning up of debt, of finances, of intimacy, of collaboration. I certainly think that this is a brilliant financial energy for you, because in the first 6 months of the year, you might have seen something financially that needed your attention, or something that intimately connected you to another body, whether it be an organization or a person. And at this point, you're getting a fresh start. Not to mention, you're going to have that Jupiter-Pluto happening on June 30th. So you've got this opportunity happening here. These energies here are your fresh starts in your favor. And you may even see some money coming in, or a windfall or something like that, or you overpaid in insurance or a bill or something like that, and it's coming back around your way. So keep your eyes open for some goodness to be available for you. September 9th through November 13th, we've got Mars retrograde in the energy of Aries. This is going to light up your fifth house. Now, during a Mars retrograde, we suggest that if you can avoid booking elective surgical procedures, that you do that, because Mars and Aries are over the energy of war and cutting and surgery. Your surgeon, they fall under these energies when it's surgery time. So if you can avoid it, go ahead. If you've got to have surgery, you have got to have surgery, right? Like, you just pray, you put yourself in the universal box, and you go do what you need to do. But if you can avoid scheduling it at these times, that is to your favor. Now, Mars is not entirely uncomfortable in this retrograde, because he's in the energy of Aries, one of the planets that he rules. So he's not thrilled to be flipped around, but ultimately it could be worse, right? So here, this is going to light up your fifth house. Now, with Mars retrograde, this is your action, how you're actually doing things, how you're getting things done, where you're putting your energy, your desire for things. Where's your fight? Where's your umph that you've got that you give to something? Here in the fifth house, you may be looking over things that you do with children, something around children, you know, how have you been parenting? How have you been grandparenting? Fertility things. This could be back on your table. This could be something that you're dealing with. What I can tell you is that really allow this timing to show you if you are fighting the right fight, right? Because, and it doesn't even mean that you're necessarily fighting like it's terrible, but are you putting your energy into the right causes, in the right direction? Is what you're doing actually meaningful? Now, I also do think that for some people, this is a very romantic energy. The fifth house is the house of beginnings, conception, and that also means romance, business, all of these kinds of things. So somebody from your past could be coming back and they'd like a second chance, or you guys would like to give it a second chance. And all I can tell you is sometimes these work. If somebody comes back, look at if they deserve your energy. If you broke up 2 weeks before Mars retrograde and they come back and they say they've changed, it's been 2 weeks, they haven't changed. Okay, you need more time. Make sure that you're gonna put your energy, your effort, and your desire in the right place, because you absolutely deserve the best. And remember, this is a big kid year. You have to evaluate this just a little bit more, okay? And now the other thing I will tell you too with this Mars retrograde in the fifth house, if you're not having fun, it's time to remedy that, right? If your action and your energy are not going into play and pleasure, you're a fire sign. put the passion back into your world. Put that passion back into your world. You can also use your Venus retrograde to make sure you're getting some delicious connections as well. But it is a year while you're growing up. You don't have to suffer while you're doing it, Sagittarius, okay? All right, November 30th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in Gemini at 8 degrees. So again, the 7th house is lit up. Now you will, let me tell you this, December 14th, we've got a solar eclipse in Sagittarius. So this is a fresh start for you. But the fresh start in your relationships, your new perspectives, you've had some psychological deaths that have happened. You've had some perception deaths that have happened up until the November timeframe. So you're working with a new pair of glasses, Sagittarius. You're seeing things from a different perspective. And this has mostly come from the things that you saw, you acknowledged, and you re-looked at during the Venus retrograde. This energy, think back to what changed for you there, because you'll be able to connect that to these adjustments that are happening here. But that solar eclipse in your sign is giving you a fresh start, a fresh beginning, new launching out, new connections to people, places, and things. You get to represent Sag a little bit differently. December 17th, we've got Saturn moving back into the energy of Aquarius. So again, coming and stationing for quite some time in this third house work. So you're gonna do third house work, how you communicate, that book, that website, studying, your siblings, anything that has to do with thinking, communications, details, any of that kind of stuff will be back on the agenda. And it's gonna be in place until 2023. Now on the 20th, Jupiter also moves into the energy of Aquarius. So again, lighting up the third house. And on the 21st, Jupiter and Saturn come together in a conjunction in the energy of Aquarius. So globally, what does this look like? This is a big deal. When Saturn and Jupiter come together, they're called the rulers of the age. As we move into the age of Aquarius, these will be our rulers, and they're over laws, economics, politics, religion, wisdom. They are over these things. It's structure meets wisdom. So this benefit in your particular energy is so good for getting your thinking together, so good for getting your mind right. Our societies have changed. Our world is changing. Where, Sagittarius, are you needing to bring new perspectives to the table for yourself? Where does your thinking need to change? Where do you need to outgrow what you have learned before? It's like you discover, discard, and rediscover something else. And Sagittarius, where do you need to understand with this particular energy that in order to bring serenity to some of the chaos that maybe you've been experiencing, whether it's personally, relationships, financially, globally, where do you need to figure out where you're not always right, right? This is okay to have perspective change at this particular part. And where do you need to allow new technology into your life? So these will be great questions to consider. Now, one of the other things I would give you to consider is think back between 2012 and 2015 when Uranus and Pluto were dancing together. What changed for you? What was the change that happened for you? Because something significant changed. You got a new idea, you got a new perspective, and you weren't ready to handle that yet. This is your turning point with Jupiter and Saturn coming together. Now you're prepared to handle it. Now you can find your space in the global world, the global voice, the global community, and even in your local space, because you weren't ready during those years. It had to bake and marinate, and now it is ready to become pie, okay? So think back. Please let me know in the comment section down below what's manifesting for you. And I hope, Sagittarius, you have an absolutely brilliant year. Remember, whatever comes up for you, there's help available. You don't have to walk through alone, but it is a big kid year nonetheless. All right, Sagittarius, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I look forward to walking with you every month and every week of 2020. I'll see you soon. Bye.